What's up, y'all? Alvin here, and in this video, I'm going to tell you everything I know about Tippett, and I know a fair amount. All right, so here's what we're going to talk about. What is Tippett? Why you want to use Tippett? What do all those numbers and stuff mean? And some of the kind of specific use case scenarios for the different types of Tippett. All right, so what is it? Tippett is a couple of different things, actually. So if you buy a tapered leader, it's going to have a Tippett on it. So typically that little number at the end, the X number, is the Tippett size. So that is the Tippett that is on your leader. And your Tippett material will have a similar type of designation most of the time. We'll get into some of the details why it might not have that. So it varies from leader to leader, but that X size, that 2X on this particular Tippett, is the size of the Tippett. And there's going to be anywhere from, you know, a foot and a half, 2 feet, to maybe even 4 feet of Tippett at the end of the leader. So that's going to be that X diameter. We're going to talk about the X diameter as well. And the reason you have Tippett is so that you can repair that leader. So you change flies 3 or 4 times and you're cutting into that Tippett every time. And pretty soon the leader is too thick to reattach your fly, or you're just not getting the stealthy presentation that you want. So you're going to have Tippett material to replace the end of the leader. Tippett material comes in all different sizes and different shapes and different materials, and we'll talk about all that. But basically, most of the time, the reason you're going to use Tippett material is to repair or extend the life of your tapered leader. There's a lot of different numbers and a lot of different technical specs. First off is the X size. So that's going to tell you the diameter of your leader at the very tip, and it's also going to tell you the diameter of the Tippett that you're using. The X size is going to start typically with a 0X and then go down as small as, you know, 7 or 8X, you know. So the smaller the diameter, the larger that X number will be. So 0X is going to be much heavier than 7X. And it is a measurement usually in fractions of an inch or millimeters. So 0X is going to be 0.011 of an inch and 28 millimeters, depending on where you are in the world. As that diameter goes down, the X size goes up. Now, there's some situations where that won't be the case, like this Tippett material. See, this is just 20 pound and it just has the pound size and not the diameter as the dominant number on the packaging. But if you look closely, almost always, if there is a pound size, there will also be a diameter. So this 20 pound test is 0.013 of an inch. So that's larger than 0X, and it's also a larger or a higher pound test. You can get kind of lost in the weeds with this diameter versus pound test. You know, super strong material will be a smaller diameter and a higher pound test. And that's something that you might want to look at when you're buying your leaders. Typically, freshwater, like trout leaders, they're gonna typically be the highest pound test for the smallest diameter, because a lot of times you end up fishing with fairly small diameter material for smaller flies or delicate presentations. And that would make you want to have the strongest stuff for the smallest diameter. Now, the flip side, if you're fishing for bass, you're fishing for saltwater fish, you're fishing in situations where you're going to have to worry about abrasion, you may want to go with something that's actually a larger diameter for the same pound test, like, you know, this saltwater leader material. So you'll see that a lot. Okay, so this is a 20 pound material that they're calling a saltwater Tippett versus this super strong freshwater Tippett. This stuff is 0.013 of an inch, and this stuff here is actually 0.020 of an inch. So much larger diameter for the same pound test, but this is gonna be much more abrasion resistant than this stuff. That's one of the things you'll see out there. Another thing that you'll see that comes into play a lot of times is fluorocarbon versus mono. So fluorocarbon is a I wouldn't say new. It's been around for quite a while. This is Orvis's version of fluorocarbon. They call it a mirage because the thing with fluorocarbon is it is almost invisible in the water. It's also a little bit larger diameter, typically for the same pound test, so a little bit better with abrasion. It does tend to sink a little bit more, so maybe not the best thing to use with dry flies. And there's a whole, you know, wormhole conversation debate that revolves around monofilament versus fluorocarbon. I do use fluorocarbon on occasion, but in my experience, I haven't really noticed a huge difference. It is definitely much more expensive. It is definitely going to be harder for the fish to see, but you know, in a practical world, I haven't had a real need to go with fluorocarbon consistently over regular mono. Probably for me, the biggest difference that I'll use fluorocarbon for is using a slightly larger diameter for more abrasion resistance. And then that way, maybe I lose less fish because it's more abrasion resistant. But practical purposes for me, I haven't seen a huge reason to go with fluorocarbon over regular monofilament. All right, so that's some of the kind of details of this stuff. Like I said, you can get really lost in the weeds on that. If you have any questions, comments, additional information that I'm missing here in the video, definitely throw that in the comments. Also, if this stuff is helping you out in any way, you know what you can do to help me out is to subscribe to this YouTube channel and give the video a thumbs up. If you really want to help me out, there's a link in the description. You can sign up for my email list, and that way you can keep up with me no matter what I'm doing online and offline. All right, so back to the video. All right, so what are some of the reasons you would want to buy tippet material, and what are some of the things that it can do for you? We already talked about the first thing, you know, where you can repair your leader, your tapered leader. But another thing is you can do all types of stuff with your tippet material that will help your leader be more versatile. So typically you can go up or down a size or two with your tippet material and match it to your leader. So say if I have a 2X leader, I can taper it down to 3X or 4X and still get a good knot, maybe even able to go up to 1X if you wanted to make it a little bit more abrasion resistant. So that way you can buy a 7.5 foot 2X leader and you can fish with 2X tippet, you can fish with 3X tippet, or you can fish with 4X tippet. So it makes that leader a little bit more versatile. The other thing is, you know, I've got all these different diameters of tippet material here, you know, like tons of spools of tippet material. I typically will tie my own leaders, especially for bass and for saltwater. So by having a bunch of different spools of tippet material, so starting at like 60 pound and tapering all the way down to 20 pound, I can just build my own leader. So if I want something with a long butt section and a short tippet to help turn over a big fly, I can make that. So tippet material is really versatile. And if you're interested in tying your own leaders, I made a whole video about how I make hand-tied leaders by hand. There's a link to that right up there. Check that out. So yeah, tippet material is something that you absolutely need. Tippet material is a couple different things, the end of your leader and something you can attach to the end of your leader. There's lots of numbers and stuff, but really it's pretty simple. Larger number, smaller diameter. It is an essential item to have. I started off and I didn't really know much about tippet, and I was burning through a lot of leaders because I was changing flies, and then all of a sudden I go to the fly shop and they're like, dude, you need to buy some tippet. So I bought some tippet and it changed my life. At least it changed my fly fishing. Anyway, hopefully this stuff has been helpful for somebody out there. Like I said, if you like this kind of stuff, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. Hopefully I will see you in the next video. And in the meantime, good luck on the water.